सो हेलो गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू एलगॉड्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर फेमस इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन ऑन एरेज। सो दिस इज रियली एन इंटरेस्टिंग वन, सो वॉच द वीडियो टिल द एंड एंड नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट। Read the problem statement and then let's try to devise a solution for it. So the question is maximum sum in a particular configuration, right? So let's read the problem statement. So the question says that we are given an array is zero based indexing, right? And we need to find the maximum sum of I into A of I, where A of I denotes the array element at index I. And we need to find this over all the indexes I, where starting from 0 to n minus 1, right? Now the twist is that we can rotate the array either clockwise or counterclockwise any number of times, right? So let's say if our array is given to be 8312, so this is the original array. If I rotate it once, so this 8 will go to the end, so it becomes 3128, right? Now if I rotate it further, then 3 would go to the end, so it becomes 1283, right? And again rotating, so it becomes 2 8 3 and 1. Now if I rotate again, it would become the same array, which was basically the original array, right? So now we need to maximize this sum, summation I into A of I, where I varies from 0 to n minus 1, and the additional information is that this array can be rotated in any manner, right? So in the sample case, let's see when it was the original array 8312. So the answer was 8 into 0 plus 3 into 1 plus 1 into 2 plus 2 into 3, nothing but the indexes here, right? Okay, let's do this. Okay, so the sum came out to be 11. Then when it was rotated 3128, so the sum was 3 into 0 plus 1 into 1, 2 into 2 and 8 into 3. That summed up to 29, and similarly for the rest two cases, right? So these were the four cases of the array in the sample input, right? And the maximum of all of these is 29, and our answer is also 29. Right, so we need to rotate the array in any fashion we want, and we need to determine the maximum possible sum. So the brute force approach which strikes our mind is that we can rotate the array every time, and for each possible array we can calculate the sum by iterating over it in a linear fashion, right? So the array can be rotated n number of times, right? Since here n was 4 and there were 4 ways in which we could form an array, right, by rotating. So there would be n ways to rotate the array, and then for finding the sum each time you would take a linear loop, and that would run n times again. So the time complexity in this case would be in order of n square, right? So this is the brute force time complexity. We need to optimize it further to the best possible solution, right? So so as to reduce the time complexity, we have to see the fashion in which the sum is changing when we are rotating an array, right? Okay, so let's note down this array and try to observe the pattern, right? So our array was 8, 3, 1 and 2. Now let's mark the indexes as well, so it would be easier. So in the indexes were 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now in this case the sum was 8 into 0 plus 3 into 1 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 2, right? 8 into 0, 3 into 1, 1 into 2 and 2 into 3 or 3 into 2, whatever, right? And it was equal to 11, right? Now let's see when I rotated the array once, what the sum came out to be. So when I rotated from here, द एरे बिकेम 3, 1, 2 and 8. राइट, नाउ द सम इज इक्वल टू 3 into 0 प्लस 1 into 1 प्लस 2 into 2 प्लस 8 into 3. राइट, सो इट केम आउट टू बी 1 + 4 = 5, 5 and 24, इट बिकम्स 29. राइट, सो हेयर द सम केम आउट टू बी 29. नाउ लेट्स ऑब्जर्व दिस पैटर्न इज दैट व्हेन 8 वॉज शिफ्टेड व्हाट हैपन टू दीज एलिमेंट्स. द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ 3 वॉज 1 टाइम, द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ 1 वॉज, आई थिंक वी मेड अ मिस्टेक हियर, 1 वॉज 2 टाइम्स. राइट, ओके, सो इट इज 1. सो द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ 1 वॉज 2 टाइम्स. राइट, एंड द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ 2 वॉज 3 टाइम्स. राइट, नाउ इन द न्यू एरे द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ 1 इज ओनली 1 टाइम. राइट, द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ 3 इज 0 टाइम्स एंड द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ दिस 2 इज नाउ 2 टाइम्स. सो इट डिक्रीज फ्रॉम 1 to 0, इट डिक्रीज फ्रॉम 2 to 1, इट डिक्रीज फ्रॉम 3 to 2. सो एक्सेप्ट दिस एलिमेंट ऑल द अदर एलिमेंट्स कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन डिक्रीज बाय 1. राइट, सो वी नीड टू, इफ वी ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द रिलेशन बिटवीन दिस सम एंड दिस सम. राइट, सो वी नीड दैट ऑल द एलिमेंट्स एक्सेप्ट द एलिमेंट विच वॉज रोटेटेड देयर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन डिक्रीज बाय 1. सो लेट्स कॉल दिस प्रीवियस सम एज एस डैश एंड लेट दिस न्यू सम बी एस. सो वॉट्स द रिलेशन बिटवीन दिस एंड द प्रीवियस सम. सो इफ आई ट्राई टू फॉर्मुलेट अ रिलेशन, सम कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन वॉज डिक्रीज ऑफ ऑल द एलिमेंट्स, लेट दैट बी एक्स. राइट, एंड नाउ वॉट वॉज एडेड फर्दर टू दिस वॉज दैट दिस रोटेटेड एलिमेंट और द एलिमेंट विच गॉट शिफ्टेड एट द एंड वॉज इनिशियली हैविंग अ जीरो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन, बट नाउ इट हैज अ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इक्वल टू द लास्ट इंडेक्स ऑफ द एरे विच इज बेसिकली नथिंग बट एन माइनस वन एंड इन दिस केस इट इज 3. सो what was added was let's say my I was here, so this element which was shifted array of I minus 1, its contribution increased or it added further to S by n minus 1 times. So this is the relation which we have formulated by observing the pattern, but still what is pending with us is that we need to calculate this value of x. Right, okay, so now let's try to calculate the value of x. Right, okay, so let's again write the array. It was 8 3 1 2 and my I is pointing to here. So I need to sum of all these elements should be decreased from this s dash, which is basically x, only 1 time. Right, because you see that here its contribution was 1, it decreased to 0, 2 and 1, 3 and 2 and so on. So we need that once the sum of all these elements 3 plus 1 plus 2 which is 6 should be decreased from S. Right, so x is equal to 3 plus 1 plus 2. Right, now by adding the element which was rotated and subtracting it once, there would be no effect on x. Right, so let's write this as 8 plus 3 plus 1 plus 2 minus 8, and we know that 8 is the element which was rotated, or we can say array of I minus 1. Right, okay, now this is nothing but the whole sum of the array, or you can say it the cumulative sum. Let's call it c is equal to the sum of the array elements. Right, okay, so x is equal to c minus, and this 8 is nothing but the element which was rotated or array of I minus 1. So this is the value of x which we have got. Right, so now let's put this value in S and final pattern formula. Right, okay, so now S comes out to be S dash minus x, and x is this, so S dash minus c, minus minus would become plus, array of i minus 1, right, and added to array of i minus 1 how many times? N minus 1 times, right? So let's better it, right? So it would be s dash minus c plus array of i minus 1 1 time added to array of i minus 1 n times, n minus 1 times, so it becomes n times only, right? So this is the final formula which we have built by considering both the sum first of the original array, and once the element was rotated or the array was rotated basically, then the sum was s, and initially the sum was s dash. C is equal to the sum of all the array elements, and this is the element which was shifted or rotated at the last. So this is the formula which we have got, right? Okay, so now let's try to analyze the complexity, and then we would go for the dry run over this array, right? So you see that this value C, which is basically the sum of all the array elements, can be calculated in a single loop which would take order of n time complexity, right, for this C. Now for this S dash, we would need an initial value to start with, right? So that can be also calculated in linear time, because we just need to determine sum i of i for the original array, right? And this value is just nothing but multiplication of the array element and n. So this can be calculated in order of one time, right? Now for all the n rotations, we are computing the new sum n O of one complexity only, because this is pre-computed, this is pre-computed, and this is calculated in O of one time. So for every rotation, we are working in O of one time, and we earlier said that there would be total of n rotations, right? N minus 1 basically, if we do not count the original array. So the time complexity is in order of n now, right? And furthermore, we are using only variables to store some pre-computations, so our space complexity is in order of 1, right? So this is the time complexity and this is the space complexity, right? So now let's have a dry run and try to see if we can find the correct answer or not. So our array was 8, 3, 1 and 2, right? So initially we need to first find the value of C, which is the cumulative sum or the sum of all the array elements, and that is 8 and 3, 11 and 1, 12 and 14, right? So the value of C is 14, and we need some initial element S dash as well. So let's calculate it. So again, writing the indexes over it, 0, 1, 2 and 3, right? So 8 added 0 times is 0, 3 added 1 times is 3, 1 added 2 times is 2, and 2 added 3 times is 6. So it comes out to be 6 plus 5, 11. So initially the value of S dash is 11. Again, you see we formulated it in O of n. Now let's start running our variable I for the rotation parameter, and I would start from 1 and it would go till n minus 1, right? So initially the value of I is 1, right? Okay, so now initially the maximum possible sum would be only S dash. So our maximum sum is S dash, and which is equal to 11 initially, right? Okay, now let's start the loop. So I is at 1, so S now becomes S dash, which is 11 minus C, added to array of I minus 1, which is 8, multiplied by N, and the size of this array, N is 4, right? So 11 minus 14 is minus 3, and added to 32, it gives 29. So 29 is greater than the maximum sum, so we update it as 29. And furthermore, now we upgrade our I as well, I becomes 2. And this value n minus 1 is 3 here, right? So now s dash would become 29, because for the new array we have to see the past array for it, right? So s dash would become 29 as well, right? Now computing the next sum, so s becomes s dash minus the cumulative sum or 14, added to, now our I is pointing to 2, so the previous element is 3, right? So 3 into 4. So 29 minus 14 gives us 15, 15 and 12 is 27. So 27 is not greater than the maximum sum, so we do not need to upgrade it. And again changing the s dash to 27. Now our I is changed to 3, right? So our I points here. So again let's calculate the value of s. So our s comes out to be 27 minus 14. And now the previous element in this case is 1, right? So 1 added 4 times. So it is 27 minus 14 is 13. 13 added to 4, it becomes 17, right? So initially it was 11, then 29, 27 and 17. And you see that it is not greater than the maximum sum, so we would not change this. And out of all these, the maximum value comes out to be 29. Right, so let's see to it if these values are correct or not. So these values were 29, 27, 17 and 11 as calculated, and the maximum sum is 29 only, right? So by starting from the brute force solution of order of n square, we finally observed a pattern between the two arrays, the original and the rotated one, and using that we formulated this formula to calculate the answer in order of 1 for each rotation, and there were n minus 1 rotations. So the time complexity for this approach is in order of n, and we were only using some variables for the pre-computations and maximum sum as well. So the space complexity is in order of 1. So I hope you would have understood the approach. If you have any doubts, you can join our Telegram group. The link is given in the description below. Thank you guys.